In today's video, I will show you how to remove stutter or jitter from your video if you shot it using 30 frames per second or lower using the Retime and Scaling function in DaVinci Resolve. Welcome to Ask William. In order to successfully slow down any video footage, you will have to have your camera settings set at 60 frames per second or higher. The equation is simple. In order to achieve slow motion, you will have to slow down your video. 60 frames per second means that your clip will contain 60 images for every second of your video. Slowing down your footage by 50% means that you will now have 30 frames per second, which matches your export settings perfectly and will result in smooth footage because there are no missing frames. 30 frames per second means that your clip will now contain 30 images for every second of your video. Slowing down the footage by 50% means that you now have only 15 frames per second available, which will result in jittery or stuttering footage because 15 frames are now missing. If your camera settings were set to 30 frames per second, your only option will be to reshoot the scene. But sometimes you get the perfect shot, only to realize in editing that your camera was set below 60 frames per second. Well, thanks to DaVinci Resolve's Retime and Scaling setting, there is a way you can remove stutter and save your otherwise unusable footage. In this video, I will show you how to rescue a single clip, but bear in mind that you can use this on a project basis too. However, rendering just a single clip with Retime and Scaling enabled will slow down your PC to a crawl. So if you intend to render a complete project, I suggest you put a day aside just for your project to render. Let's get into it. Under the Edit section in DaVinci Resolve, select the clip you want to slow down. Under your top right menu, make sure that your Inspector tab is selected. Under the Speed Change section, change the speed percentage value to the amount you want to slow down your footage to. In this scenario, I shot a clip at 30 frames per second and wanted to slow it down by 80%. Rendering out a clip without using retime or scaling the footage will look like this. Notice how the video stutters, trying to stretch out those 30 frames. To fix this, scroll down to Retime and Scaling under your Inspector tab and turn it on by hitting the throttle switch. All your default settings should be set to project settings. Next to Retime Process, select the drop-down menu and select Optical Flow. Optical Flow is an enhancement on how your frames blend with each other. Imagine this as adding a video transition between every single frame in your video. Under Motion Estimation, select between Standard Fast or Better or Enhanced Fast or Better if you do not have a high performance PC. For the best result, I suggest you select Speed Warp. Speed Warp takes optical flow even further by using DaVinci Resolve's neural engine and machine learning to create new frames. The best way to explain this is, if this is your first frame, and this is your second frame, Speed Warp will create a new frame or frames in between these two images, thus adding more frames to your clip. Once you activate Speed Warp, it'll make previewing your clip almost impossible. But once rendered, the Speed Warp setting will give you the best overall result. Go to the Deliver section of DaVinci Resolve and render your project. Now go take a nap, because this is going to take some time. In comparison, rendering this 10-second clip without retime and scaling took only 3 seconds. With retime and scaling turned on, the same render took 4 minutes and 30 seconds. But the result is quite astounding. Again, here is the clip before. And here is the clip after retime and scaling was applied. In a side-by-side comparison of these two videos, you can clearly see that the one on the left is jittery and unusable, but the one on the right is smooth without any stutters. So, adding retime and scaling to your arsenal of editing tools is a no-brainer. I hope you found this video useful. If you did, consider giving it a like, and please subscribe to my channel to be notified when I create more content like this. From me, William, thank you so much for watching till the end, and I hope to see you in the next one.